الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Thank you again for joining us this session of 15 minutes after Fajr prayers here in Toronto. But of course people also from other places are welcome to join us. I can see already Mamdali Bhai, who had a problem yesterday, has joined us today. Alhamdulillah, he could do that. So yesterday we discussed about that why we chose this dua, the reason for that. I won't repeat it, but most important, as we can keep in mind, the Prophet said, "Man hassana minkum fi hadha ash-shahr khuluquhu kan lahu jawazan as-sirat yawma tazilu fi al-aqdam," right? If anybody is going to just improve and cultivate his akhlaq in this month of Ramadan, then he will have a jawaz, he will have a pass to go over sirat on the day when the feet are going to just tremble, right? You're shaking. And we said that there are many hadiths on sirat, which we won't discuss, but yesterday I discussed that there's a very good book. If some of you are thinking of reading a good book during Ramadan, then I would recommend you this book. The title of the book is Towards Eternal Life by Sheikh Muhammad Saeed Bahmanpour, and translated by Sheikh Abbas Jaffer. If you go to the Foundation website, you can download e-book or even Kindle, or you can even order here in Toronto. You can also get the bookstore. So it's a good book, worth reading, especially if you need to read something in this month of Ramadan. Also, I had promised you that I'll just very quickly share with you a hadith. So here is a hadith which very quickly I would go through it. One is, remember we said just now, the Prophet said, if you are going to improve your akhlaq in the month of Ramadan, then inshallah you are going to be able to pass all the sirat, you'll have the permission to do that. Another hadith, he said, he whose daily bread is earned through his own toil and labor will pass across the sirat. See? So make sure that when we work hard to just earn our earning, it's important, that means halal earning, then that will help you to pass over the paradise very quickly. The second hadith, again, because of limited time, we won't get much into it. The second hadith, of course, is that it talks about our belief, right? That all these things are belief. For example, here is, then I ask him, acknowledge the value to befriend, he's befriend Allah. This regarding the 12th Imam, this hadith continues, because this is Sheikh Saduq al-Tawheed, right? And then we say, we have to affirm every day, verily, the ascension, miraj is true. The question in the grave is true, Heaven is true. Hell is true. That means, وَالْجَنَّةُ حَقٌّ وَالنَّارُ حَقٌّ وَالصِّرَاطُ حَقٌّ وَالْمِيزَانُ حَقٌّ, right? Do you know the dua which we recite this thing? There's a dua which wherein we try to affirm these beliefs. Anybody knows? That dua is dua Adila. My mother, Marhuma, may Allah bless her soul. She actually, since I was young, had always advised me to recite this dua Adila. The Adila is almost like you reciting your own talqin in your lifetime. When a person dies, somebody will dictate to you talqin. But in your own lifetime, if you recite the Adila, that is your confirmation about your belief. So in this, for example, in this hadith, you can see we've been told to always affirm, to say that miraj is haq, questioning the grave is haq, heaven is haq, hell is haq, wasirat haqqun, wal mizan haqqun, right? Also, all these things is there, is important, so keep in mind. Now, we go to the dua itself. Dua passage number one. It begins, as we said, this dua contains 20 times this solution, this formula, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali. This is repeated 20 times. وَبَلِّغْ بِإِيمَانِي أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ وَاجْعَلْ بِيَكِينِي أَفْضَلِ الْيَكِينِ وَانْتَهِي بِنِيَّتِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسِنِ النِّيَّاتِ وَبِعَمَلِي إِلَىٰ أَحْسِنِ الْأَعْمَالِ. What we'll do every day is that we will read the Arabic in front of you. And then, of course, there are two translations. As we said yesterday, we gave you also the website. You can download both the translation. So for you, as I'm reading the Arabic, you can very quickly read the translation to get an idea what is there, right? So you can see, O Allah, this is Allahumma sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, bless Muhammad and his household and his family, right? وَبَلَّغَ بِإِيمَانِي أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ. Oh Allah, make me, reach the faith, the most perfect level. Do you see this thing? It is important that we are all mu'mineen, inshallah. May Allah accept our iman. But you can see here, imam, person like Imam Sajjad al-Islam, such a great imam. We know about him. We have discussed about him over in our lifetime, right? During majalis. He says, "Wabaligh bi imani akmal al-iman." Oh Allah, make my faith to reach the most perfect level of iman. Do you see? And that is why you find in Quran, these ayat, Allah says, "Ya ayyul ladina amanu, aminu." No? All those who believe. How can that be? No? It's because that iman does not only have one level. We have to continue increasing our level of iman, right? Watch al-yakini afdal al-yakin. In Allah, when it comes to yakin, first of all, yakin is that certitude. That means you have no doubt about it, no, about Allah, about the day of judgment, about the prophet, about, no, as we just asked, about sirat, about heaven, about it. You have no doubt. You've got yakin about it, right? Watch al-yakini afdal al-yakin, the best of yakin. I remember reading this book, 40 Hadiths of Ayatollah Khomeini. There's a beautiful thing which he has mentioned there, I have never forgotten. He says that when you are going out and as you are coming out of your home, you meet your friend. And your friend says that don't go to this path, don't go out by this path because I saw a lion just hiding there. You would avoid, right, going to that path because you are afraid. In the same way, he says, when the Prophet, Allah has told you in Quran, when Prophet has told you that there is hereafter, there is hisab and kitab, no, there is punishment in the grave, then why do we commit sins? Because we don't have yakin. If you have yakin, if you are certain, then we would not commit sins, right? The same, you can see Imam says, al-yakini afdal al-yakin. Wantahi bi niyati ila ahsan niyya. And then, oh Allah, make me just, take my intention to the best of intention, ahsan niyya, right? Not only that, enemy goes to, make my, for example, cause my motive to be the best of resolution. My intention should be best of asana niyat. So also niyat should be very sincere and the best of niyat. Wa bi amali is al ahsan al amal. And the action is the best of actions. So we'll always try to go. I usually use this passage when I talk to students. Those students, I tell them that in your life, you just go for the best. You can see here, Imam al-Islam is using the superlative degree. Malik imani, akmal al-iman is a superlative, the most perfect iman. Afdal al-yakin, the best of yakin. Again, superlative degree, right? Ahsan al-niyat, the best of the niyat. Ahsan al-amal, the best of the deeds. Do you see? So imam is trying to achieve the best. And that is why this is dua makarim akhlaq. That means you try to have the best of akhlaq, the most exalted of akhlaq. We go to the next slide. We started 2 minutes a little late, so give me the 2 minutes. No. This is ayat which we recite all the time. When, for example, death takes place, we recite Surat al-Mulk. It's important to recite Surat al-Mulk in Kabastan, right? The second ayat is often quoted by the speakers. No, they say, Alladhi khalaqal mawta wa lahayata liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsanu amala. Do you see how highlighted the word ahsan amal? Usually we say that Allah has created the death and life just to try, but no. Here Allah says, Allah will not only try, He says, ayyukum ahsan amala. Liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsan amala. It's a golden phrase. That phrase, it can change your life. It says, liyabluwakum, so that Allah can try you. Who is the best in deeds? And just now we are going through trial, right? We are going through this pandemic whereby we are homebound. We are going through trying. So let's try to make our deeds the best of it. And then of course, when you come to niyat, very quickly, I've just taken two hadiths. Sunniya da'un dafin, right? Evil intention is a hidden malady, is a hidden disease. If somebody's intentions are evil all the time, then that's a disease, it's a bimari, which is hidden, no? Imam says. The first Imam also says, Aniyatu Asasul Amal. Intention is the basis of action. So keep that in mind. Intention is the basis of action. We have to have a good intention. We go to the next slide, and that is, as we have promised, that after 10 minutes, we'll go into